man, he is still on the throne, even in a day such as this. We're going to take a moment, actually, just to pray. I certainly need to pray, trying to get settled in here on this very hot day in the beginning of July. Oh, my. It is hot in the sanctuary, too. I'm back in a familiar place, amen, sitting here on the pulpit. Bishop, I can think back, all the years is, man, back to Bishop Paddock, and really especially Bishop Harry L. Herman, who was my pastor most of my life, all from the time I was born. Amen. And here in this sanctuary and thanking God for my honorable pastor, Bishop, Suffragan Bishop Tony Thomas, amen, who sits in these places as well. So he normally would be down on the ground teaching from another location, but we in the same place. Hallelujah. It's the house of God. It's not unfamiliar. This is the best setup. These old pulpits, amen, sturdy, amen, and they've stood for many great men and women of God have stood in this space. Hallelujah. It's an awesome thing. My mind takes me back to the time seeing bishops sitting over to the side, and Bishop Herman and Bishop Thomas eventually, amen, and seeing them sitting there and being behind you with the strong word of God that they taught. I mean, a powerful word of God. And you have great trembling in your spirit that you get it right and don't make any mistakes on the word. And you don't want a big mistake, an error there. You want to make sure what you're saying is right and is backed up by the word. That's one thing about these churches. What we believe is to stick close to the word. A lot of people choose different things to select from and not the word of God. Anything I say, please, I'm praying that the Lord Jesus, and we're going to pray just quickly, but I'm praying that I stay in the word, that I say the things which are right, and that you can take the book and actually, if it don't come out of here, if it deviates and goes so far left of what the scripture says, then we have a problem. We have to find out how we can get back to what the actual word of God says and not just any opinions that I may have about this or that, even in my church's opinion. What does it matter if it didn't come off the book? What if it doesn't stand, if it doesn't check from back to front, from the Genesis to the Revelations of this text here, I could just say anything. Anybody can just say anything or believe any kind of thing. We are blessed. We have a ruler, hold that ruler up and you can find out if it really is 4 inches. Just grab the ruler and see if if it don't line up with 4 inches on these rulers. If we got good, real ruler, it should all line up with the same 4 inches. This book is that good, that it's that thorough, that when I stand on it and I check it out, I can look at it and see that these words are according to what the book actually, that is, if it doesn't measure up, if it doesn't stand the ruler of this book or of these texts that we are reading from. And by the way, I'm a linguist, so I deal with languages. So it might not be the book is written. I always check it for the students. And even when I was teaching in the juvenile home, I always tell them, we're dealing with the same books. What is it? It's 2 testaments that we have to read. There is the Old and the New Testament. And we go from Genesis to about Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. That's the Old Testament. And we go Matthew all the way to Revelations of the New. It should all line up in there somewhere in these books or this text. We need to know what it's talking about from here. What I say should actually, hopefully, we'll come back and line up to this. So we start to read from the word, but let me pray real quickly. Dear God, we do thank you today. Hallelujah. We give you praise. We give you, I'm here by myself, Lord. I give you praise, and we collectively, globally, give you praise, God, for your goodness. We give you praise for your name, Lord. We thank you for life itself, Lord God. You said, as we have even behind me, it says, enter into these gates with thanksgiving and enter your courts with praise, Lord God. And we will be thankful unto you and will bless your name. I bless your name, O God, for you are worthy. Thank you, Lord God, for the opportunity to teach. reach. Lord God, I thank you for a word, Lord God, that is not only here, but it goes everywhere, Lord God. Thank you for opening the doorways of the internet, Lord God, that we're able to express your word, Lord God, in a way that globally they can receive that word wherever they may be. Lord God, your power is great. Thank you for what you have put in us, Lord God. Thank you for life, Lord God. Thank you for strength, Lord God. I give you the glory. I give you the honor today. I am here to bless your name. I'm here to deliver the word that you have given in the mighty name of Jesus. Your mighty God, your glorious, O Lord. And I will bless the Lord at all times. And your praises shall continually be in my mouth, Lord God. I glorify you today. Collectively, Lord God, wherever that we may be seated, Lord God, or riding or walking or whatever we're doing, we collectively praise your name and give you glory and honor. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord, bless this word, oh God. Lord God, this word, let me enunciate those things that you want to have me to express, Lord God. Lord God, let me not falter, Lord God. Let me use this word, Lord God, that you have said. Lord God, as you put this tool in my hands, Lord God, allow me to share it, Lord God, with somebody. They might receive the word, your glorious word. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray right now. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. I'm here right now praying for some people, Lord God. My spirit, we in our church, we have prayer meetings. We got one that starts at 5 every day. We got one that starts at 12 every day. Amen. And I know those prayers went forward. Hallelujah. And we have prayer coming up again to later this afternoon. And what we need prayer in this day. We need the hand of God to move on this day. We need the hand of God in the midst of chaos. What seems like a chaotic situation that we're involved in everywhere we go. We need the Lord. Hallelujah. If you didn't know, I'm not here to preach. I'm here to teach. Amen. But it's something in my spirit. And first off, it's excited because this word, the Lord blessed me to get. I had it trying to find the space. And this phone ain't going to die for me in the name of Jesus because I got the book also. Hallelujah. Real physical paper. Hallelujah. And when I think about it, I just get excited because I know the Lord is doing something. Oh my goodness. It seems chaotic. Yes, again, I keep using that word. It just seemed like chaos. Amen. It just seemed like everything is going on in a way that who would have ever thought a few months ago. And I know I said this before, and I've been here 3 times. It's my 3rd time being able to preach this way or teach this way and express this way. But I'm telling you, I've been looking ever since the beginning, like who would have thought? Amen. That it would come where you wouldn't be in school. Amen. During the school time. Amen. School done packed up right now. It's done for the summer at KZOO anyway. And when we look at that, we're looking at the fact that, and we say Kalamazoo, KZOO, as we are at Kalamazoo Christ Temple Church in Kalamazoo, Michigan. As you're looking at that, it is the glorious, amen, the church of the air today. Hallelujah. Expressing the word of God here from this place. When we look at it, with all that's going on, everything seems to be shut down. Stores sometimes, actually it's been a long time, somebody believe look like a movie or something where the stores are barren and where you actually feel like you're almost fighting for people and things have closed down to the meat markets, even have stopped producing meat or putting meat out for people to be able to get. They having problems distributing those things. Oh my goodness, it sounds apocalyptic. I speak French, right? So the Bible says in the Bible in French they say l'apocalypse. So apocalypse is apocalypse. So in the apocalypse, the book of apocalypse, which we call Revelation, the book of Revelations, amen, of this time which is coming when the Lord is soon to come. He given us the orally revelation of the fact that he's on his way. I want y'all, if y'all listen to Brother Boyd, I want y'all to know that you can't forget that Jesus is coming back. Hey, hallelujah. Jesus is coming back and he's on his way. We getting caught up with so many things and it's unfortunate. It's sad. By the way, you look at what's going on in the society today. And that's part of what I really want to talk about. The Lord put that on my heart that he provided that word that way. Oh, help me, Jesus, as I bring it out. And I ain't got long, but long enough to tell you all, because I could tell you a lot in a little time. But in the name of Jesus, when I think about all that is going on right now, it's in the middle of a distraction period for us. Oh, hallelujah. Help us, Jesus, not to be so distracted. Oh, God, help us get ourselves in the focus where we are supposed to be. Today, I'm talking to the general public, to everybody. Amen. The church, when we come here, it's so everybody can hear. Otherwise, we sit somewhere and I could call you on the phone somewhere. I just send you a text message about it. And I can do that. I do that too. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you, it's been wonderful because right in the midst of this time period, amen, a time period we're locked out, necessarily, we're here at the physical building. Amen. And we're in this sanctuary. They're observing all the things. Amen. I happen to be here mostly by myself right now. In fact, my sister assisted me today in getting some things. And they call even this recording today. They're doing a lot of this stuff online and over the internet and over the telephone. Oh, my goodness. You'd be amazed. The Lord set it up for this for us. I remember I was thinking we were blessed this past week in our churches, our presiders, they've been taking the time to send a snippet and a reminder of some things that were said in the past. And when they sent it out over the airwaves, it was Bishop Wagner this week. And I was thinking about when Bishop Wagner talked about the reason why God set up things like airplanes is not just for people to be able to travel in their own way, but it's so the word, that saint of God who was going to carry the word of God from Michigan to California, amen, was going to be able to get there. And then Brother Boyd to get across the water to head over to Sierra Leone or to wherever I need to be in Africa or it needs, the word must go forward. And he knew he had a word. He would send that, dispatch that word all the way wherever it needed to be. That's what the stuff was set up for. It was set up so that the word could get there that way. It was set up for this time right now so that we can be able to deal with this. So we got this internet stuff that we've been working on and working on and working on. And now look at the word of God being expressed from Michigan in the United States in a little city there. We ain't the littlest, but we're not the biggest either. This little small city here in Michigan in the United States being dispatched. I got word today that there's some folks looking right now from London. And praise the Lord, saints in London. Amen. I like to listen to the services they got over there. Amen. The service when they're playing. I love the music because it's got a little funny, y'all. Forgive me for this. They got a little reggae beat in the tone of their music there because they don't sound, everything don't sound just the way it do here. But I was amazed when I walked into the sanctuary over there and I was listening to music like, what is this? But it's their praise in God. They're still calling the name of Jesus. Amen. Whatever the musical sound may be, they're still giving God glory. It was God that caused that to happen anyway. Thank God for using the gifts that we have. Amen. Those, it's just our voice. Amen. It's to glorify God. Hallelujah. So much is going on. So many people talk about so many things. But we're here to talk about Jesus today. Amen. Let me go with y'all real quick. Y'all know I have to calm down. Amen. We're calling on Jesus. Amen. To work in this place. Fill the house. Amen. Again with his presence and with his power. Let the word go forward in power. Hallelujah. Let it go forth, Lord God, in power, Lord God, in a way that people can receive. Let them hear not from Brother Boy. Lord, let them look through him, look past him. Hallelujah. And see you, Lord God. What are you saying to the church? What are you saying to their heart right now? Wherever they may be, for one or the other, saved, unsaved, no matter what it is, let them hear your word, Lord God, the call that you're giving to them. Lord God, as we're going in this last day, Lord God, as we're in this time, Lord God, when you are so cool, you're so soon to come, oh God. Hallelujah. Let us be woke. Lord God, be awakened, Lord God, by the time, Lord, by the word that is going forward. We thank you in the name of Jesus. Today, if you have Bibles in front of you or around you, and we have all these devices, look how you can carry the word with you wherever you go and don't have to make a big scene about it. Amen. The phone can have your Bible right on it. Amen. Thank God for the blessings with that. Amen. We're in the book of Isaiah right now. Amen. Chapter number 57. Amen. I'm not going to do my normal jog because I like to jog a lot through the word. Amen. I was thinking about it today. I like to go through and see a number of things. Like I said, if you see it's hot today, and like I said, we just got my sister, the setup that we got. My sister was able to set up, turn up my brother, the sound man, Brother Wise, amen, who's doing a great job. I mean a great job. If it wasn't for him, a lot of things would not have taken place or been able to go forward. I'm praying the blessings of God on him and his life in the name of Jesus. And again, I say this also. I'm praying up front also for Right now, I got word this morning for some of the times I've been in Ghana. It was a wonderful thing. One time we were in Ghana, and when we were over there, we passed under the leadership at that time of Evangelist. She wasn't doctor yet. She was doctor, but she wasn't bishop yet. She is now Bishop Mona Reed, amen, who is there in Sierra Leone. She's for the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World. She is the bishop there. And when we went there this time, one morning they said to me, you got to, one of the ladies that was there, she said, you got to come down here. You should talk to these people that are going and they need to hear. So early in the morning, I went down that morning before we went out, actually. I went with them and I talked to them about stuff and about salvation. And I can't help it. It's in my blood. I really wanted to start today with John chapter number 3 and start in verse 3, 5 through 8. Y'all check it out in your own good time. Amen. John, St. John, because there are four books, John, with the name John on it. St. John chapter number 3. Amen. Start in verse number 3 and you can go through to verse number 5. And it was concerning the man called Nicodemus, if you haven't heard it for a while. Nicodemus, amen. And he was told, he was asking about Jesus, what must I do? Because I want to go to heaven. He said, well, you must be born again. You must, I'm going to say it real loud again. You, Jesus said, you must be born again. Might sound funny to some folks, but you must be born again. You got to be washed. And he said, well, I don't understand that because it don't make sense to me. You're telling somebody to be born when they're old. He said, no, you must be born of the water and of the spirit. That was born of the flesh is flesh. That was born of the spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I say unto you, you must be born again. He said, that which is when we're in this life, Lord God, the wind blows where it wants to go. You can hear the sound of it, but you can't tell where it comes from. But I want you to know everybody that is born of the Spirit has a sound. Everybody that's born of the Spirit has a sound, because Jesus, of all the things he said, is you can feel the feelings and you can see the effects of it. But it's what Jesus emphasized, there is a sound that goes along with the Spirit. I'm sorry, I get diverted on that because it's very important. Every time I'm listening to everybody who's been speaking from this pulpit or this space, wherever they've been at, they feel with the Holy Ghost. They've been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. I did not say baptized in Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, and that's what they spoke over you. Jesus didn't say, speak over me, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. That is not what he said. Jesus did not say, speak over them, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. He said, baptize them in the name, singular. There's only one of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, but one name. And the one name we have found out, if you read the whole Bible, not about baptism in the whole text of the Bible, says they baptize them in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. You don't ever see that repeated again anywhere. That is not what it says to us. It says you must be baptized in the name of the one who is the Father, the Son, and Holy Ghost. Guess what it is? Jesus. Because every baptism in the Bible, you always see them calling on the singular name of the Lord. Amen. The same singular name of Jesus Christ, the singular name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We'll find it there. Check your Bible out. I know I'm right because I've read the covers from cover to cover. I'm still working on my French reading because I want to get through the reading of this text now in French. I still am working on it. Pray for me. Brother Boy going to get through that too. But anyway, I know what it says is the same thing. I read French and read the French Bible and the Arabic ones too. I'm reading those things. God, hallelujah, his word is consistent. That's why they can receive this word. I hear them preaching it in Arabic. I know the churches and wherever they may be in the globe, I'm be quiet. Amen. But they are there preaching the word all over. Hallelujah. In various different texts. It don't matter. The thing has to happen. You wonder, like, we just got it here in our location. No, the Holy Ghost is everywhere. Amen. The baptism fell in somewhere, wasn't here in the United States in Michigan. Hallelujah. But it did fall one day when I was here. Hallelujah. It fell on me. Hallelujah. It came into my heart. Hallelujah. And you need it in your heart. That's where that joy is. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sometimes not feeling so good in the physical body. Hallelujah. But all the Spirit of God on the inside of us. Somebody I know is lighting up somewhere right now. Somebody is excited right now because Jesus lives on the inside. Hallelujah. God forgive me if I get hyped, because I am, hallelujah, with the Holy Ghost, with the power of Jesus, hallelujah, living on the end. Oh, the Bible says the Lord is that Spirit. I don't know. It's something when I was studying today, it came across my mind when I was thinking about it. It was crossing my mind that people get a difference and a misunderstanding. They don't act like they don't understand that there is really only one God. Oh, I sometimes get excited. I know sometimes this is off the, now y'all forgive me. Hallelujah, because this text is true. What it says, when it says, la, la, ha, la, la, they be talking, I speak, that's the Arabic thing. By the way, that's a part of the Muslim creed kind of coming in. They believe in only one God. That, why would they? Why wouldn't they believe in only one God, by the way? They're the children of the way of Abraham. Amen. And the firstborn was not Isaac. Amen. He was not the firstborn. There was Ishmael. He was the firstborn child, which we really tend to believe, and if history is right, or things that we understand about history, that it comes through what we see of Islam and the Muslim people, Muslim faith, which they are strong about one God. Why are they strong about one God? Because that's what Abraham taught them from the beginning. There is only one God. And even ourselves, we know, some folks then added many other. I could go down the religions that are polytheistic and have different ones. There is only one, and it's wonderful to know his name. What I know about that, aha, Allah, by the way, the word Allah, y'all say, oh, Allah, put him aside. Guess what? The word Allah is the word that is used in the Bible for God himself. I do this because I just want to tie it in. I have read in my text that I've had by Arabic text Bibles. The Bible says, "Fil bada khalaq Allah as-samawat wal ard." What that says, that sounds weird. Well, for those that don't understand, you can't if you don't. But, and that's why speaking in tongues is so good. Because when you're speaking in tongues, we be thinking, all they're doing is gobbledygook up there. They just blah, blah, blah. You don't make it up like that. The Holy Ghost speaks to you. One of the many languages that he himself created and allowed us to communicate in, right? The Holy Ghost speaks a language you do not necessarily understand. It ain't for you to know it. The Bible says it's Spirit of God gives the utterance. It's the Spirit of God that causes you to speak in another language. So it sounds real funny to you because you don't know that language. Commence à parler français avec les gens ne comprennent pas. It's your press, don't le nom de Jésus. Hallelujah. When I begin to speak French, people don't understand what I'm saying, but I'm preaching in the name of Jesus in French, though. Voila, it don't sound real. I don't understand. It's blah, blah, blah to me. That tongue, when you start speaking in them languages that God speaks through you, hallelujah, with the Holy Ghost. I spoke a whole bunch of languages that I know I had to cover the gamut when I was talking in tongues right here in this church. Hallelujah. I was speaking in the language. Hallelujah. We were down in the basement in what we called the prayer room at that time. Hallelujah. We come tarrying and seeking the presence of God. And one night I received him. And when he came in, he filled my heart with joy. Hallelujah. The Spirit of God is in me today. Hallelujah. That's why I got to go here. Let me get this text. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're in the book of Isaiah. Hallelujah. Book of Isaiah. Oh, la, la, Messiah. Hallelujah. I be trying not to speak in tongues all loud all over. And the Bible says we got to do wisely with that. Hallelujah. We sometimes speak in tongues a lot, and y'all don't understand what's going on. The Bible teaches us further in the book of 1 Corinthians, around about chapter number 14, I believe, it tells us how to handle, because some of us have the gift of tongues. Everybody ain't got the gift of tongues. Everybody doesn't have that gift. Now, everybody may speak in tongues during various periods, perhaps throughout their saved experience with God. But hallelujah, when you speak in other tongues, amen, the Bible does give us even instruction on how that should be used. And some folks focus on that. Them a lot of times, the folks that don't even believe in speaking in tongues, hardly themselves, or don't do it themselves or whatever. And most times when you haven't had that experience, you won't speak. It sound weird to you. You don't understand it. But all those that have received, because when it comes through that first time, especially, it's something about it. oh my God, the days, I'm getting carried away. It's another thing that I wasn't trying to go to. Let me give this word also, because it's funny, because where I'm in it at even right now, I'm just looking at the Bible. We're in Isaiah, the 61st chapter. I really could start in 59 as well. Amen. But I'm just going to the 61st book. 61st chapter of the book of Isaiah. Amen. And I'm going to read there. Hallelujah. I'm excited. Sorry if I'm full of praise like that. If I'm just getting carried away, because it is exciting. Hallelujah. It's exciting to have God living in you. To have God come to take residency in your life and in your heart. Not just something that's up in the head. It's not just a mental thing. Like, because I could think all kind of, I feel good thoughts, I feel good feelings, and I could do all of that all day. That ain't the Holy Ghost necessarily. That probably might not be. It's just somebody was nice to me today and said hello, and I'm feeling wonderful. That ain't the Holy Ghost. That's just you and your good feelings. That's just what's in your mind, and that's good. I ain't saying it's negative. It's a positive thing, but I want y'all need to know about the real Holy Ghost. When we hear what I was about to say earlier, is that when we hear, you're going to hear it constantly and constantly. We keep on talking about it. Why? Why are we so stressed about the Holy Ghost? Why are we always, I ain't saying stress, why are we stressing about the Holy Ghost? By the way, we're not just in the U.S. like that. I keep trying to stress that out to you too. That we're not just here talking about this. All over the globe, they're talking about the same. When I got to Egypt, when I was there in that place, amen, the saints of God, I went down to a place down in the south, the upper Egypt, they call it. It is weird because the Nile River flows differently and stuff. It goes from the south to the north and everything. That, when I was there, do you know when I got there, there were some saints of God that I met in Egypt, amen, baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and filled with the Holy Ghost, with the evidence of speaking other tongues as the Spirit of God gives them the utterance, the same thing. Everywhere you go all around the world, it's the same song here. Hallelujah, it's the same song, because the Word of God is consistent. It don't change for me. It don't change for you. It is the same word. Hallelujah, it's the same word for life for people to get. Amen. So again, I'm starting here in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 61. And it says this, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. Today I'm asking y'all, get the Spirit of the Lord God to be upon you. I think about Bishop Herman. One of the things he constantly talked about is that some people have the upon experience, where the Spirit of God actually sat on them. Old prophets particularly, when Isaiah, they didn't have the Holy Ghost yet. Huh? They didn't have the Spirit of God there in that first place where they were reading. But he said here, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. And this, you will find this is an Old Testament text that Jesus Christ used himself. Later on, he said that the Spirit of God, by the way, the Lord, the Bible says clearly, emphatically, thou the Lord is that Spirit, which is crazy. That's why we ought to understand Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, that's all in one. There are not three gods we're going to see when we get to heaven. I'm just like, read your Bible and you will understand. There is only one God that sits on that throne. Amen. One God. And don't say there are three and multiple different thrones. There's one throne. One throne. Jesus sits in that throne. Wherever it is, whatever it is, physically or spiritually speaking, the throne is different than what we think. It's a little time we're looking at the one chair that is just saying Jesus is the people of God, by the way, are the throne. Amen. And Jesus is in the midst of that throne. Oh, God, that's so deep. That's too much revelation. And I ain't got time for all of that. I really could go on with it. Hallelujah. Because it's deep. That's why you got to come to the church sometime. Sit in somebody's Bible class or get on one of these. Get on these lessons that we got going on. I don't know, somebody going deep. We're trying to get the immediate necessities today. We're trying to get the immediate thing. Biggest thing I talked about right now today is salvation. You need salvation. You need the new birth. You need the new birth. Jesus didn't say it's an option. You can be born again. you all should just like being real nice about it. You all should be real nice and be born again and just follow away. No, he said you must be. You talking about you want to see the kingdom of God? If you're not, he said you cannot see nor enter into the kingdom of God unless you're born of the water and of the spirit. He said you can't see it, can't enter it, unless you're born of the water and of the spirit. Then I want to know how do I be born again? You're born again. His example, he himself played it out for you to see. Let me give you an example. I'm going to go down here. It is necessary for me to fulfill all righteousness. I got to do everything that's right so you can see it. Even though I am the Holy Ghost, let me just show you. Even though I am the Father, amen, let me just show you what it's like, what you can do. And it says, he was water baptized by John the Baptist, if you remember. When he got water baptized, the Bible says he came up out of the water. Amen. The Bible says a dove lighted upon him as a spirit to give inference that the spirit was there. Amen. It shows the Holy Ghost sat on him like as of a dove. And the Bible says that the voice came from heaven saying, now this is my son in whom I'm well pleased. He been water baptized. You see the Holy Ghost is there now, and now this is my son. Now the Father talking out of him, even though he is that Father. He says, it sounds real crazy, but it ain't. It sounds real good. You can be many things at once, by the way. You're a bunch of things right now. You're probably somebody that's probably a mother or a father, amen? And if you got kids, that's what you are. But guess what? You're also the son or the daughter of somebody. Did you change people? No. You didn't change people who you were. Hallelujah. You're the same person. Hallelujah. You're the same person, but you are father and you're son. And guess what? Somebody in here is a boyfriend or a girlfriend, or you're really the husband or the wife of somebody. Amen. Yeah, but did you change people? I'm talking to the same one. You got the same name. Hallelujah. I call you your answer to that name because you are that. Amen. But there's a number of things you are. You're probably an employee. Amen. Or you're somebody laid off or temporary place. Amen. And we bind that in the name of Jesus. Give them what they need in the name of Jesus. We're praying together. Amen. We all need it. Amen. So, I mean, whatever your position is, whatever the meaning, name of what you are, you're a cashier, you are employed at a bank, you're a banker all the time and doing all these things at the same time. Your role may be different. Sometimes you can even do something that covers both roles at the same time. You're the same person. God is just the same. We are made like him. Amen. Sometimes we are the same place where we are multifaceted in our many things. God didn't limit us. Amen. And he is not limited either. He is the French just messed up with it. Illimité. So it is French that it says that it's unlimited. Hallelujah. What I'm saying is that the Lord is there. I ain't got through the first verse. Let me read some more because it's exciting. What motivated me with this today? Because Johnny James, who was what we used to call him, the walking Bible. He has that memory, photographic kind of memory. I mean, and biblically, he don't read the Bible as much anymore. He does every year, amen, normally, but he doesn't have to, it's in his head. He don't have to look it up because it's there. Amen, y'all got to check the internet and see if you can find some things with Reverend Johnny James, amen, a great brother preacher. Amen, but he taught us really you should preach on the things because he taught lessons on the how do you deal with minister, being minister, what do you preach and all of these. And he said you should pray preach what the Lord has put on your heart. Lately, let me help. I'm probably helping some of my brothers and sisters. If y'all, some of us out here get stressing about this or that, worrying about what I don't know if I can look. What has the Lord been dealing with you? Hopefully, you didn't crack the Bible somewhere in your life. Hope you've been listening to some preaching, somewhere that's been inspired something in your mind. But what is the Lord dealing with you with the Word of God? And so, we're giving you what the Lord has dealt with us about, what He has given us about for this day and where he's been at with my heart a lot. Of course, you can't live right now and not see in America, in the United States, with all the deadly killings, unjust seemingly. I believe that's my feeling, amen, about a lot of things that are unjust, are just wrong. just cold-blooded murder, senseless, and what from the good or the bad. And I am of the mind, to be honest and being straightforward, I have a number of cousins that have worked in law enforcement and all of those kind of things. And they're good people. They're positive people trying to do the things that are right. So I do not stand against them. Amen. But I certainly can stand against the things that I see that are wrong also in those places when they go there. Amen. But I also don't want to be so caught up in so much of the other stuff that I don't tie us all the time back to the main thing. Your soul needs to be saved. Your soul not needs to be saved. You need the Holy Ghost. You need, look, you want to deal with the wrong that's going on? Get the Holy Ghost. That's where you're going. And people getting the Holy Ghost is the more folks that have the Holy Ghost are born again, that are saved, they are the ones that can tell you more about what they need to do to make peace in the earth. We are supposed to be the peacemakers. We are supposed to be the ones that, carry for the peace of the Holy Ghost in us. Oh, the word, what I liked about this word, the Lord, because I'm asking my own self, Lord, how are we supposed to respond to this? How are we, even the born again, saved people, supposed to be responsible because we still live in the world? Though the Bible lets us know we're not of the world. Amen. But how do I respond? Because I still got to go do this or that. I still have to maybe even find something to eat at the store. Lord, help me. What am I supposed to do at the store? Like how am I supposed to act? There is a fear that can come on you just in a natural way from a lot of things that have happened. It's really a time of great distress. Amen. How am I supposed to respond? How am I, that is your child, because once you're born to someone, and you're born again, you're a child of God now. Now that I'm child, Lord, as a child, what am I supposed to do? And this word really came to me because I felt like it illuminated. That's why the one that Jesus spoke, he was real, he was a little brisk, I don't know what the word is, but he was real straightforward and just said, you know, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He's anointing me to preach good tidings. Amen. Let me continue to read this so you'll understand. This, I would suggest anybody writes this down. Isaiah 61. I also was really going to go into Isaiah, I believe 59, somewhere in there. Also where it's saying some of the same things, letting you know about the Spirit and about the joy of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Let me just talk about this. So the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because the Lord hath anointed me. We are anointed. I'm sorry, the French stuff coming to mind. When did they tell that? So the anointed of God, the anointing of God. That's we could just say almost the ointment, amen, of the Holy Ghost. It is like something he applies to us, but his anointing. But his anointing is on the inside. Because when I'm filled with the Holy Ghost, amen, when I'm filled with God, Jesus, why I say Jesus lives in me. Jesus is the Holy Ghost. Now the Lord is that Spirit. Bible says there's only one Spirit. Amen. And for us to know, it's take note of, Jesus is that Spirit. Amen. So anyway, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings. What is my job? And if I was going to, my brother asked, what would I title this? I couldn't think of the title I would have given it. Amen. But what is it? My job is to preach good tidings. Amen. Good tidings for salvation. Good tidings for those that have need of salvation. Good tidings to the world. Oh, wow. Good tidings in a time like this, in a time with Ebola, just might as well be, but we're dealing with it in a time and a situation. Some are dealing with that. Amen. We got brothers and sisters over in Sierra Leone and all over the world. There's some saints, amen, that are struggling with different things. By the way, the same pandemic, as you know, it's everywhere. It is all over the globe. They are shutting down things all over. There's been shut down schools, been out everywhere. That ain't just here. All kind of places, they're still dealing with the same stuff. But as they're dealing with that, hallelujah, the anointing. They need the Holy Ghost. They need that anointing. They need that healing. They need some good tiding of great joy. Amen. That's what Jesus came to bring. Y'all remember he came to bring good tidings. Amen. On that day when Jesus was born. Amen. Y'all know the whole story about Jesus and the Virgin Mary as you recall, when he was born, amen, behold, he brings good tidings. Amen. The angel came to say, good tidings of great joy. Jesus is coming on the scene. Hallelujah. Jesus is coming on the scene. Jesus is the, y'all want some happiness? You need to get Jesus around you. Hallelujah. You need to get Jesus in you. He says, good tidings unto the meek. Hallelujah. He said, he has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted. What is our job? I guess that's what I'm asking. What is our job? What are the good tidings? What is my responsibility as a saved person? Hallelujah. Y'all forgive me because I get to be, I'm a little more on the passive side. I'm on the aggressive, but I'm on the passive. Aggressive when it comes to the word of God. Aggressive when I tell people you need to be born again. I know it's not the real cool message. I know it's not, it don't bring a whole lot of people. I know some folks quite frankly don't like it. They get mad about it. Like they get tired because they bored of it. I get aggressive. I'm aggressive telling folks, yeah, Jesus is coming and somebody going to hell. Ooh. Oh my God. Somebody going to hell. Oh, don't say that. Everybody ain't going to heaven. Hallelujah. You must be born again. And if you didn't get it right, well, I'm scared. I don't know what to say about what's going to happen. I'm sorry if I'm aggressive. Forgive me. But I do try to be nice and gentle with it. I'm sorry, but sometimes I'm aggressive because that's like getting a whooping. Y'all forgive me. Yo, every whooping I got, we had the kind of whoopings that I don't want to talk about all the pain. But they did come. Amen. But it was for a reason. My brother, God bless them, and I'm praying for them. Thank God for their blessing today. They were married on 777, something like that, right? Today is their day. Congratulations and happy anniversary. Amen. Thank God to them. If they ain't listening to me, but if they do happen to hear the word of God, they can know. Amen. We're giving them good tidings, but I thank God when they left them with all that information, that love, they left me the keys around. Oh, my goodness. My niece and my nephews, oh, they've been there. Oh, help, Lord Jesus. It's exciting to me. Amen. I praise God for that. It's been joyful, but it's been an experience. Amen. There can be high stress and all that kind of thing. It is exciting. Yes, bless the Lord. Amen. But we have this thing, and we want to get that word is there for them. Even in the youth, they have to be corrected. They have to be directed. They have to be given the instruction of what they need to do. Amen. So we can follow. We are the same, amen, in this day. We sometimes got to hear even those things you don't want to hear. Amen. Even the things that are not comfortable, that are not light, that are not easy sometimes, you still got to do them, and you got to hear what is there. Thank the Lord for his grace and his mercy to us. Amen. So at this time, we're coming back to the main focus of this. Good tidings unto them that are meek, to the meek. And he has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted. What is our job as saints? What is our job as saints, the born-again saints, those which are filled with the Spirit and given the Spirit of love and power and everything? We are to carry the hands of God to mend the brokenhearted. People have to be able to interpret for themselves what it is that God is asking them to do in the brokenhearted, what it looks like for me to bind up the brokenhearted. What does it mean for me to bind the brokenhearted? Amen. Brokenhearted, and hallelujah, the brokenhearted, and to proclaim liberty, freedom to the captives. Amen. There's a number of things that we can do. Amen. We can do a lot of things. Amen. Right now, you can't even go to too much work into the jails or to the juvenile systems or anything like that because of this. But guess what? We're getting creative. Hallelujah. We got word that we have found out a way to be able to communicate and dispatch the word of God into some of the situations of incarceration that are right here in our great state of Michigan right now. We got some missionary folks right here that is doing a work, sending the word of God to those that are needing it there in the prisons right now. Y'all know it's all kind of things going on, but they're there right now. We take the word of God to them. Folk get saved in the prison. I've been there. I've seen them get baptized in the name of Jesus Christ and filled with the Holy Ghost right there in the prison. Sometimes that's how people wake up. God, all this trial that we're going through right now, it might be how we wake up right now to be able to do what God is calling for us to do in this last day, giving us the time to be able to do it. Bless God. Hallelujah. Bless God. Amen. To bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives. Hallelujah. And the opening of the prison to them that are bound. It's not all physical. Amen. Much of the binding and imprisonment and captivity, captive to the works of Satan, captive to the adversary's demands on our lives, hallelujah. Captivated by so many of these, but God is preaching freedom to us. Those that are locked and chained up with sin, God is breaking the shackles, hallelujah. I ain't singing all them songs, amen, but I could. Amen. And break every chain. Hallelujah. God does it. He is able to do it. Amen. To appoint unto them, hallelujah, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. Hallelujah. When is the acceptable year for us? Amen. Now is the time. Hallelujah. The word came to me. Now is the day of salvation. Hallelujah. Heed to the master's calling to us. Now is the day. When you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Don't get stiff. Don't get stiff right now. You hear God talking to you? Jesus is calling you. Don't you want to go? I'm sorry if I'm getting song in. Like somebody, some of y'all need that. Y'all sitting in your house and a song need to catch your spirit from something from the past that God, Jesus is calling you. Don't you want to go? Yes, I want to go. Amen. The day you hear his voice, harden not your heart. That's why we did do the baptisms and things. That's what we did. When the Lord was dealing with and stirring us, that's the day they need the Holy Ghost right then. They don't need to wait. They don't need to learn for another 3 years. And then sometimes somebody, I can't say how the Lord is moving in everybody's life, but I can say I do know they need the goodness today. They need the Holy Ghost today. They did not, because ain't no promise that you're going to wake up tomorrow. Ain't no promise that you're going to get another. I would get on a telephone. Oh, Lord Jesus. Somebody need to get on a telephone and call to Elder so-and-so. To Sister Evangelist, Preacher so-and-so, somebody need to hear about this word because I need the Holy Ghost today. Look, the day I walked into I was in the prison and the brother and the juvenile and they were talking about they want the Holy Ghost. Guess what? That day they received the Holy Ghost. That day, because there ain't no waiting, you can't have the Holy Ghost. You can have the Holy Ghost in your house. You can have the Holy Ghost receive him right in your apartment, right there in the street. I just heard that you will see some people receive the Holy Ghost right on the street. It just in a parking lot. That just happened. Just happened. Just went down in the name of Jesus. Within one day, the Lord turned things around. And there's need for help. There's always need for strength. We all need prayer one with the other. But God is there now. Get in the game. That's what I always say, get into the game. Have you even, I know it's not a game, it's life. The game of life is the game for salvation. But get in the game. Don't even keep talking about it. Amen. Don't just be looking at, you ain't even on the scale yet. Other than, I'm a person that believes that when I get born again, that ain't normally the first thing that has happened. Amen. There was a seed that was planted in my life, in my heart. It may have rested there dormant for some time, but it took something. So all the things that you have been through, those were just prepping for the day for you to get saved. They were just prepping you for the time the Lord was coming. Amen. Hallelujah. It was just getting ready. That little word, your little attempt to go to a church. Amen. They weren't talking to you about being born again and all that stuff in that deep way like that. They was just like saying, shake my hands and come down here and give your heart and all that kind of stuff. That, and I'm not going to knock it altogether. That somebody needs to stand up and say, Lord, I need you. And I recognize the sins that I've had and I've done wrong. That's a part of repentance. Hopefully you'll go deeper and take it all the way and repent fully in your heart. Turn everything around in your life. The mindset. Get your mind right. Get your spirit. I am directed not to serve myself. Lord, I am sorry for what I have done. Oh, God, but I intend with your help. I know I'm powerless to do it myself. God, I've tried many times to get it right. But with your spirit, God, I can get things right. I need your spirit in my life. I want you, God. I need your Holy Ghost to come within me. Wash me. Forgive me from my past. Hallelujah. Cause me to be able to walk in the ways of God. I'm sorry if I just gave y'all the plan of salvation right there, because I just did. I'm sorry about being sorry, because I need to tell y'all, you need to be born again, whatever it takes. Yeah, so go through that phase. It's all right you went to that church here or there. I don't know that that's not the stepping stone that God needed for you to make it to the right thing. You had to have a little softness to hear that word, to whatever the method is. So I'm not going to knock them. They got to do what they got to do. But we are given this word, according to the full text of the Bible, says you must be born of water and of spirit. You must repent of your sin like they did on the day of Pentecost. Peter said unto them, Acts 2:38. Y'all want to check Acts chapter 2, all the whole thing. So from 1, chapter 1, he told them, you shall receive the Holy Ghost, and you shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, uttermost parts of the earth. That's what Jesus said. That's what Jesus told them. I'm trying to tell y'all, look, I ain't talking Brother Boyd's words, because Brother Boyd, he's an okay guy. Amen. Thank God. I think I'm okay. You know what? But it ain't from Brother Boyd. That don't matter. What matters is what does the Bible say? And I'm hoping that wherever you go into church, that they will line it up according to what the book actually, the full breadth of what it's trying to tell you. You must be, if they miss this, they miss something. Because Jesus said, where I get it from? Jesus said, what? What? Jesus said, you must be. I know I'm great. Ain't nobody in the room, but I know y'all can hear me. Where you at? You must be born again. Hallelujah. You must be. You got to be. You have to be. Try to put in all the vernacular of today. I mean, you got to be. You got to be born again, bro. Sister, you got to be born again. You must. I'm sorry if I went to the African-American vernacular English. That's what that is. AAVE, that is a real thing. Check it. It's a linguistic term. It is part of it because that is a dialect of English. Hallelujah. Some people listening right now know are from like England and stuff, and where they link it and wherever they may be, I just encourage that that's true. I know that. And when I send it out, it's going to go to some folks from everywhere when they say that. But the AAVE said, you got to be born again, bro. Sis, you got to be born again, man. That's the way it got to be. It's just got to happen like that. You, my sister, my brother, no matter where you come from, you must be born again today. Check this verse out. I don't have enough time because I could teach a whole Bible study on it. Bishop, God, you're going to have me teach Bible? No, I'll just teach that. Now I'm not asking for an assignment, Lord. But I'm saying to you, hey, man, this chapter right here, if y'all want to know a recipe of what we the calling, what are we called to do right now? How are we supposed to respond? How are we apostolic Pentecostal? That's what I tend to go by. I don't mind saying it. But or whatever, as a real Christian, born again, because you ain't born. The ones they call Christian was people that was already born again. The ones they call Christian were those that were baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost. Check your Bible. And you'll see where it first happened. I'm sorry, because I stand out strong on the word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. Check the book, and you'll understand. My encouragement is to you today, what are we supposed to do? I don't know. That's why I couldn't find a title. What are we supposed to do? How are we supposed to respond? Does it line up to what Jesus was saying? I know that, again, this is Isaiah. Jesus had his preaching that he had to do in the book of Matthew that says the same. It's the same text. He was actually citing back, by the way, it's his word anyway. So he was just citing back to something he had said through the mouth of Isaiah in Old Testament when he stood up in the New Testament and said the same thing. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Hallelujah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. It's on him. He just was quoting it again about his. I ain't going to go through that. The one guy. There we say there's one way to God, one way to God, one way to God, baptize. We some say in Jesus' name. And then we say, baptize with the Holy Ghost. I'm glad to be filled with the Spirit. You can have it. You can have him today. You can have him today. right where you're at while we're speaking. Yes, the Holy Ghost gift. Read the book. And when you read it, say, somebody said, I know some folks that got the Holy Ghost in their houses. I know folks that got the Holy Ghost in a cow pasture, literally. I mean, it don't matter. I've seen it. And I've seen it. I know that happens. It don't matter. But they were looking at us. They said, Lord, your word says this can happen. The word of God says clearly that people spoke in tongues. He heard them speaking in a language they did not learn, brought confusion to the land. And God, is that possible? Is it true? Lord, if it happened to them, why didn't it happen to me? I want the same thing. Because I don't want to get gypped. I don't like that term. It's not good. I really learned those things. Amen. I don't want to be cheated, said that way, out of the way of the things that I'm supposed to have from you, God. I repent for those things. But I don't want to be cheated from that. I don't want to miss it, God. If you gave it to them, I know you can do the same. What he's done for others, he'll do the same thing that God said in, if you read chapter number 10 of Acts, which, by the way, don't skip Acts. Acts is the book that shows the history of the church. What happened actually with the earliest church? We're supposed to look just like them. We're supposed to have everything they had. If I'm skipping over that book and I ain't reading and I ain't studying, and that stuff that's in that book didn't happen for me, I ain't never seen that before. Lord, help us line it up. Help us get it together. Help us get it. I want the same thing, Jesus. I know you're the God for everybody. I want what this book says, and you can have it. I'm here to tell you. You can have. We ain't that exclusive. No, you can come be part of the exclusive kingdom of God that is very inclusive. Amen. But he does got some exclusions. Amen. He'll leave it out if you don't follow his word. Follow his word. I'm done right now. Let me pray right now in Jesus' name as we get out of here. Dear Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, for your goodness, Lord God. We thank you for your grace. Lord, again, I'm thanking you, Lord God, for your blessing. Thank you for the joy of your spirit, Lord God. Thank you for being born again. Thank you for having filled me with your spirit, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Are we perfect, Lord God? No, but we're born just like any baby, Lord God. Hallelujah. And babies got to sometimes be cleaned up. Sometimes babies got to be stood up. They can't walk like they need to sometimes. But eventually, you give them strength to get up and walk. No, we didn't start off here perfect. We started probably more perfect than we were with just like any cute little baby, Lord God. Hallelujah. In the spirit, Lord God, we're the same thing. Boy, we came in here with power. God, we came here flooded with that spirit, Lord God, and with the joy of you gave us life. You have breathed the breath of life into us. We thank you for that, oh God. Lord Jesus, and I praise you, Lord God, for my brothers and sisters. You did that for them, Lord God. Help them, Lord God, to be able to make it in this day. Help somebody else to know how to get the experience, oh God. The Bible, you said that you draw us. We can't even approach you unless you draw. I'm praying, Lord God, and we are praying, Lord God, that you will draw people to know more about you, to seek you. And you said when we seek you, Lord God, we will be found of you. Lord God, when we seek with our whole heart, Lord God, you will not be that far from us. You will not leave us without power. You will leave us with what we need. So we're coming to the end of this now, Lord God. We just thank you, Lord God. We thank you for salvation. We thank you for healings. Oh, we thank you for healings, Lord God. Healing my sister there, my brother there over in Sierra Leone. I thank you, Lord God, for healing. Thank you for healing Brother Collins' brother, son, Lord God, there. Touch his body in the name of Jesus, God. Hallelujah for those many that were prayed on the line for today. Oh, send healing, Lord God. Oh, God, hallelujah. We're believing you. We're praising you right now because we know it's done. We believe you, Lord God. For those that are in need, we just thank you, Lord God. In Jesus' name, hallelujah, we ask all of these things. Amen and amen. God bless you all, saints of God. And young folks, is anybody young and old, hallelujah, repent of all your sins and the Holy Ghost will enter in. That's what Bishop Haywood said. He was right. Amen. You can have it today. God bless you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.